Today we're going to use the Bernoulli's equation to see how far we can launch a jet of water using a beer bomb. So we're going to have it set up like this, and then we're going to use this equation. So we're going to set our datum right at the point where the jet leaves the tube, so we can lose our second elevation. Both the jet and the top of the beer bomb are going to be at atmospheric pressure, so we can cancel out these. We're going to treat the beer pong at the top as a reservoir, so its velocity can be treated as zero, so that also cancel out. So what we're left with on the left side is an elevation and a head loss, and on the right side we have a velocity component. Now for right now we're going to ignore the head loss and come back to that later. So we can treat it as Z1 equals to V2 squared all over 2G. Now I'm going to do some algebra to put this on all on one side to solve for the velocity. Now when we did these calculations, we got a velocity of 4.4 meters per second. Now, from that, we can do some basic projectile motion equations to figure out the time it will take to get back to that same elevation on the far end of the stream. And we calculated this horizontal distance to be about 1 meter. Now, when we run the experiment, it's probably going to be a little bit shorter than that. And that's because we ignored this component right here, the head loss. So we're going to run the experiment, see how much shorter the distance is than what we calculated, and from that we can figure out what our head loss value is, which will compare to a theoretical value we calculated earlier.
Just about topped off, so we're going.
After our experiment, we found that the water jet traveled a horizontal distance of 0.43 meters. From that, we can use Bernoulli's equation again, this time adding in the head loss, because from the 0.43 meters, we can calculate the output velocity, which we found to be 2.05 meters per second. So from that, we plug this into the velocity in the Bernoulli's equation, and our z from before was about 0.985 meters. That was like the height of the funnel, the whole system. And from that, we can then solve for the head loss, which we found to be 0.77 meters. From that, we can theorize where the head loss came from. The main two sources are probably friction and the bend in the tube. Another couple sources we thought of were maybe the diameter change in the funnel as the water goes down the beer bong funnel, and maybe some beer residue from previous use.